Brady and Belichick over the course of his life. In 2015, with the Broncos, he shut down and made Brady look stupid. He loves to bring pressure, only rushes 4-7 back. I think that maybe finally after two games of nobody getting to Brady, maybe the Rams can find a little something-something with that D-line to get to Brady. So I think that's another reason why I go Rams.
I give you one play that I think speaks more to the prowess of Wade Phillips and what he did defensively, how he can adjust. In the Saints game, and this is pointed out because the announcers doing games, they've been great at pointing things out. And they were able to point out that one of the successes that the Saints were having and that they had in the game prior to playing the Rams is that they were able to get the ball out to Alvin Kamara and get him in space, and then he'll eat up any competition that because he's just better than any linebacker that's going to cover. And they pointed out, I forget who the guy was, it may have been Jason Witten, but he said, you've got to chip him. You've got him out of the backfield. And then Ndamukong Suh started to do that. And absolutely rocked Alvin Kamara trying to come out of the backfield and knock him off course and gave the linebacker time to get over on him. I think that's the same type of thing that's going to happen because the Patriots and the Saints kind of have similar qualities with some of their players and similar game plans. I think that that's going to be something they try to get. Obviously, throw the ball a lot to James White or use Sony Michel a lot. If the Rams step up and Ndamukong Suh does stuff like that again, that's where I can see Nick Eisman.
Do you think Sean Payton's going to watch the Super Bowl, or is he going to go back to the ice cream and the Ted Bundy tapes like he did for the 3 days after that Saints-Rams game?
Well, I know he's not going to watch it with his grandchildren.
True.
Actually, I don't know. 248-539-9797 is the telephone number. Chris is in Milford. Chris, welcome to 97 on the ticket.
Hey, thanks. I think it's going to be 28-21 Patriots because I think New England's got too much on offense. They have too many things for them to stop. LA to stop. You got to stop White. The Devlin's good. Gronkowski's good. Brady's good. Edelman's good. Too many weapons for them to stop. They can't stop everything.
Well, there's a lot to account for, to be sure. Like, both teams have a lot to account for.
He didn't even mention Sony Michel.
I just believe that New England has too much on offense. I think Belichick won't fit the young coach for LA. He'll find a way to slow down Donald.
Thanks for the call. There's the experience factor, and obviously the Patriots have been there and done that, and they played just last year in the Super Bowl, and these guys have a ton of experience. The Rams do not. Do you put any stock into the young coach, Sean McVay, and trying to match wits with Belichick?
I think it's going to be fine. I think he's going to do a heck of a job. I do, and I think he's got the hottest girlfriend that motivates him. Have you seen McVay's girlfriend?
We actually have it up on our website.
Oy vey.
@someoneticket.com.
My goodness gracious. I mean, I don't know how he keeps his mind on football. I don't. Sorry, but it's true.
Well, some people don't have a one-track mind.
Well, that's true. I'm just thinking. I can imagine, like, Sean McVay headset on, you know, he's about to call a 4th-and-1 play in the fourth quarter with the Rams down 3. How does the image of your gorgeous girlfriend not pop in your head? And you say to yourself, what are we doing? What are we doing here? I'm thinking about my girlfriend. Have you seen her? She's gorgeous.
Probably because if he didn't do anything in football, wouldn't have that.
So you think he's got that innate ability to compartmentalize?
Yeah.
Thinking about football.
Yes. Yeah. You get to this level. Yeah, I don't think it's much of an issue.
I'm a big fan. That's another reason I root for you.
Bill is on a cell phone. Bill, welcome 97 on the ticket.
Morning, fellas.
Hey, Bill.
Hey, Bill.
Oh, it's just wonderful. They're staying nice warm inside the house.
It's good to stay that way.
Yeah, I hope so. Hey, listen, I've been a Lions fan for God knows how long. I'm 63, almost 64. I've gone through Kamel quarterback, the Dempsey field goal, all that crap.
Seen it all, yep.
And reason I called, there was something on TV yesterday called The List. And it's a half-hour program. And they led off with the Lions as losers, always losers, and how the fans reacted.
Yeah, they got that right.
Yeah, pretty much, you know. And it's just kind of odd that, you know, it's a nationally broadcast kind of thing, and just showing it was just the Lions.
Did it bother you?
Yeah, it did. You know, because, you know, like I said, I've gone through the war with them, you know. And it's just degrading, I guess, to say that, you know, our team is so pitiful.
Well, it's embarrassing. It's embarrassing that the Lions are one of four teams that haven't even played in the Super Bowl. That's embarrassing. And Tony Ortiz had this update just over an hour ago.
Oh, right, an hour. Right.
It's embarrassing to even hear that. It's embarrassing to think that this franchise hasn't won a championship since 1957. They have one freaking playoff win since that championship game. That's utterly unconscionable. I don't know how we can bring that up. That's the case with the franchises. You got a prediction on the game on Sunday, Bill?
I'm going with the Patriots. I'm a Brady man, Michigan man, and I think it's going to be
31-28.
31-28
Patriots.
I'm just curious. Why would that offend anybody? Why does that bother anybody? You should be used to the fact by now.
Yeah.
Bill, they've stunk, so you know what? It just comes with the territory. They're not making a Super Bowl. It will never happen. We'll all be dead, unfortunately.
But, you know, they looked so good the last game of the season. I mean, there was finally a trick play that actually worked for them. You know?
Yeah.
Why couldn't they look that good?
That was one of the classic, really good Packers teams, too. I mean, I got to tell you, that Packers team is going to go down in the history, the annals. It's
going to
go down in the annals as one of the greatest ever to suit up.
Why did he have to suit up?
Yeah. Look good.
It looks so good.
I mean, Aaron Rodgers played fantastic in that game.
Exhibition game, the last game of the season.
Played great in that game.
Well, one thing's for sure. They made DeShone Kizer look fool.
Sure. Matt Stafford looked unbelievable. I mean, really, I got to believe momentum will carry over.
I don't want to rehash that last game of the season and how kind of meaningless it was.
Lions just scored again. And again.
All right. Let's move on from that because I was just pathetic. Pathetic. Finished this season. They won it, great, but
bad finish to the call, too. Let's be honest.
Yeah, not happy about that. 248-539-9797. You brought it out of him, too. He was fine up until that point, Jeff. I don't know why you bring it out of people. 248-539-9797 is the telephone number. In addition to the Super Bowl, obviously, we've had some weather to deal with this week. Got a question about that and how you dealt with it here on 97.1, The Ticket.
Carl Galliana from Galliana's Van Dyke Dodge Ram. And Carl, what is hot on the lot?
The 2019 truck of the year is what's hot.
Yeah, that's the 2019 Ram 1500. It's been getting a lot of press since the auto show.
Yeah, it sure has been. We need to sell 15 more Ram trucks by Thursday. So we have incentives right now up to $13,000. So a 2019 Ram Bighorn Crew Cab is as low as $24,995, or at least as low as $119 per month.
What? That's crazy low for a full-size pickup.
Oh, yeah, it is. This opportunity ends soon. You gotta get here.
So, Carl, one more time for everybody out there. Where are they going? Where are you guys located?
We are located on Van Dyke Avenue, just north of 696. You can't miss us.
You heard the man, Van Dyke, just north of 696. You gotta get there. You gotta go to Galliana's. And ask for Carl. Discount price point and payment include SCA employee discount and returning competitive owner loyalty rebates at tax title, not destination to the purchase. 1782 due at signing on the lease. Lease through U.S. Bank. Tier 1 approval required. Not all buyers will.